Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss design of line shaft. We have done design of machine shaft. Now I am going to take up the design of line shaft. Design of line shaft. As I have already told you, a line shaft will be subjected to both twisting as well as bending. Both twisting and bending. So let us say T is the maximum torque or maximum twisting moment, maximum torque or maximum twisting moment on the shaft in Newton millimeter. M is the maximum bending moment on the shaft in Newton mm. The unit will be, both will be in Newton mm, Newton millimeter. Now these two can be directly given or they may be indirectly given. Directly means they will say torque is so much, bending moment is so much. It may be given in Newton meter or kilonewton meter. You have to just convert them into Newton millimeter. Indirectly means, instead of giving T directly, they can say power transmitted is so much, speed is so much. So you know how to find the torque, given power and this thing. We have already done it in the case of machine shaft. Here they may be, it may be the shaft is supported in two bearings like this. Some load, maybe one load or two loads may be acting here, two pulleys, belts, something will be there like that. Then, or it may be a cantilever beam. This is a simply supported beam subjected to one or two loads. It may be a cantilever beam subjected to a point load at the free end. Now you know how to find out, in strength of materials we have done these problems, how to find out the maximum bending moment on that. So we can find out that if you know the span, we know the load length and all that, you can get the value of M from there, depending upon what is the given problem. Depending upon that, we can find it out. Now, again, here there are two theories. One, maximum shear stress theory. We can design, or we can find the dia of the shaft. Design means we have to find the dia of the shaft. Now, it can be found out by using either maximum shear stress theory or the maximum normal stress theory. That is, maximum this thing, maximum shear stress theory means D will be equal to 16 root of T square plus M square divided by pi into tau whole to the power of 1 by 3. See, if you neglect bending moment, that is, if you consider it to be a machine shaft, that is, bending moment is negligible, means it becomes zero. If M becomes zero, this will be T square plus zero, that is only T square under root, means it will be 16T divided by pi into tau whole to the power of 1 by 3, which is the formula that we use in design of a machine shaft. So this, assuming, which theory? Assuming maximum shear stress theory. Shear stress theory, if you assume, this will give you the diameter of the shaft. If you assume maximum normal stress theory, then it will be 16 into M plus root of T square plus M square, or it can be M square plus T square also, divided by pi into permissible tensile stress here, 1 by 3, assuming maximum normal stress theory. So there are two types of design here. If in the problem they have given only tau, that is permissible shear stress only is given, they have not given this, that means you have to find it out, dia is to be found out by using this formula only. that will be the dia. If only this is given, this is not given, then you will find the dia only by this formula. If both shear stress and the tensile stress are given, then we will find the diameter by this also, by this also we have to find out. And whichever case you are getting the bigger diameter, that should be taken as the dia of the shaft. Okay, we will do some problems on this and then this will be over. Design of shafts will be over. Next, we have to take up the design of keys. So now I will do kitna hua hai. Let us take problem number 5. Problem number 5 of the question bank. He says, select the dia of a solid steel shaft subjected to a bending moment of 3000 newton meter and a torque of 10,000 newton meter. Full stop. The shaft is made of 45 C8 steel having ultimate tensile stress of 700 megapascal and ultimate shear stress of 500 megapascal. Assume factor of safety as 6. Factor of safety is 6. Now, so M is 3000 followed by 3 more zeros to convert it from Newton meter to Newton millimeter, or it is 3 into 10 to the power of 6. This is T is 10,000 again followed by 3 zeros multiplied by 1000 Newton millimeter. Now permissible tensile stress is ultimate tensile stress divided by factor of safety. So this will be 700 divided by 6. This will be tau will be equal to tau ultimate divided by factor of safety, that is 500 divided by 6. So that will be 700 divided by 6 means 700 divided by 6 will give me 116.6 Newton per mm square, and this will be 500 divided by 6, that will be 83.3 Newton per mm square. So these are the permissible tensile and shear stress, both are given. So we have to use both the formula. So first, on the basis of maximum shear stress theory, D will be equal to, this is what we have to find out. We have to find out factor of safety is given as 6. D is what we have to find out. So D is equal to 16 into root of T square plus M square divided by pi into tau whole to the power of 1 by 3. So this will be 16 into root of 10,000 followed by 3 zeros whole square plus 3000 followed by 3 zeros whole square divided by pi into tau, that is 83.3 whole to the power of 1 by 3. Do it slowly. 1 followed by 7 zeros 1 followed by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 square. Do it slowly. Plus, here, this is plus. 3 followed by 6 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros square equals. This square plus this square equals. I am getting 1.09 into 10 to the power of 14. Okay, it doesn't matter. Root of answer, square root of answer. I am getting 10,440 point something. No problem. Into 16 multiplied by this answer multiplied by 16 divided by pi divided by 83.3. equals, I get 638319 point something. Cube root of answer will give me 86.1 mm, something else 1019 1006. I get a long answer. Okay, it doesn't matter. Now what we do, this is on maximum shear stress theory. Now on maximum normal stress theory, now the formula is D is equal to 16 multiplied by m plus root of t square plus m square or m square plus t square divided by pi into this one whole to the power of 1 by 3. Tensile stress here now. Now again you have to make a substitution. 16 into 3 followed by 6 zeros plus square root of, do it slowly, 1 followed by 7 zeros square plus 3 followed by 6 zeros square, whole thing divided by pi into, this is 116.6 I think, whole to the power of 1 by 3. Do it with patience. Again same thing we have done already. 1 followed by 4 5 6 7 zeros square, 1 followed by 7 zeros square plus 3 followed by 6 zeros square equals 1.09 into 10 to the power of 14. Same answer we had got all there also. Square root of this, square root of answer 10440 something plus 3 followed by 6 zeros equals into, after this square root I have added this, again what I get answer into 16 divided by pi divided by, now it is 116.6 equals this much. I got the entire answer. Cube root of that I want, shift cube root answer equals, I am getting 77 point something. D is equal to, from this 77.70 something I am getting. Now this is 86 mm, this is this much. Here I have got this. So this is bigger than this. So this will not be considered. This will not be considered. Now what I do, I take this thing, die of the shaft. Here die of the shaft is given, table is given. Now this is 86 point something. Now after 85 the next size available is 90. So adopt, after I find out both, then I have to write adopt die of shaft D as 90 millimeter. So this is the answer for this particular problem. I hope you have understood this. We will Now, we will do one more problem. I will take up problem number 6 from the question bank. Here he says, select the diameter of a solid steel shaft made of mild steel required to transmit 100 kilowatt. 100 kilowatt at 300 rpm. 300 rpm. The supported length of the shaft is 3 meters. 3 meters. It carries 2 pulleys each weighing 1500 newton each 2 pulleys placed supported at a distance of 1 meter from ends respectively, assuming safe value of stresses. He has not given the value of stresses. In that case, we will assume the value of safe stresses as, I will take this as 80 MPa, 80 megapascal or 80 newton per mm square, and the shear stress as 60 megapascal or 60 this thing. With this, we have to find out the dia of the shaft. In case they are not given these values, you can assume some suitable values. Generally, these values will be around these values. From, if you do a number of problems, you will understand that it will be, the values generally will be here. Now, from this data, the difference between the previous problem and this problem is, in the previous problem, again this is line shaft, this is a problem on line shaft. In the previous problem, T and M were directly given, that is torque and bending moment were directly given. Here, he hasn't given them directly, he has given it indirectly. Now, from this two, we can get torque. T will be equal to 9.55 into P divided by N into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm. This will give me the torque. So 9.55 into P is 100, N is 300 into 10 to the power of 6. So that will be 9.55 into 100 divided by 300. That gives me 3.183 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm. This is the torque. This is the average torque. That itself is the maximum torque because he hasn't said anything. So this I got. What I got? I got T. So T is equal to this much. I got T from this. T is equal to 3.183 into 10 to the power of 6 Newton mm. All right. Now, from this data, I have to get the bending moment. Now here, this is the shaft. It is supported at the ends. So this becomes 3 meters L. Now, 1 meter from here and 1 meter from here. That is, this is 1 meter, this is 1 meter, this is 1 meter. There is a point load here, there is a point load here. 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter. This is 1 meter, this is 1 meter, that is 1 meter. This is 1500 Newton, this is also 1500 Newton. So it is a simply supported beam having 2 point loads. Now the total vertical load acting downwards is 3000 Newton. There are 2 supports. It is symmetrically supported. So this reaction will be 1500. This reaction also will be 1500. Now the maximum bending moment, if you draw the bending moment diagram, it will come like this. This is how it will come. this is how it will come. The maximum bending moment will be here. This is BMD. Now, what is the bending moment here at this point or anywhere, any point here? The bending moment will be this into this. That is, M will be equal to 1500 into 1. This side also it is 1500 into 1 meter. So it will be 1500 Newton meters, or it will be 1500 followed by another 3 zeros, Newton mm. That is 15 followed by 5 zeros. That is the maximum bending moment. He hasn't said take anything. So this is, this will give you a bending moment of 15 followed by 5 zeros. M will be equal to 15 followed by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros. So many Newton mm. If you want, you can do this also. T is equal to 3183 followed by 3 zeros. So many Newton mm. This can also be done like that. Now, what you have to do, as in the case of previous problem, we have to do it by both theories. By maximum shear stress theory, D will be equal to 16 into square root of m square plus t square, whole thing divided by pi into tau, whole to the power of 1 by 3. So, it will be 16 multiplied by m square, 15 followed by 5 zeros, whole square, plus 3183 followed by 3 zeros whole square divided by pi into 60 whole to the power of 1 by 3 or cube root. So now take the calculator. 15 followed by 5 zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros square, plus 3183 followed by 3 zeros, 1, 2, 3, whole square equals. I have squared this, and added both of them. I got that root, square root of answer is equal to multiplied by 16 divided by pi divided by 60 is this much. Cube root of the answer, cube root of answer will give me 66.84 something, 8449, you get a long answer, no problem, we will take that much. That is D, you considering the maximum shear stress theory. Now, considering maximum normal stress theory, it should be 16 into M plus root of m square plus t square divided by pi into tensile stress whole to the power of 1 by 3. D is equal to 16 bracket 15 followed by 5 zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros, plus root of 15 followed by 5 zeros whole square, plus 3183 followed by 3 zeros whole square divided by pi into, here this is 80 whole to the power of 1 by 3. So now D will be equal to that, you can 15 followed by 5 zeros square plus 3183 followed by 1, 2, 3 zeros square equals, added both of them, root of answer will give me something like this, plus 15 followed by 5 zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros equals something, into 16 divided by pi divided by 80. 319502 something, point something, cube root of answer, cube root of answer will give me 68.36 something mm. So this is 66 point something, that is 68 point something. They are almost near each other. Now the next available size here is, after 65, the next available size is 70. So adopt. Anyway, we got the same answer in both, 70 mm as the dia of the shaft. That should be the answer. That is the answer. This is how it should be done. I hope you have understood this. You can do some more problems. I have done a few problems. You can do some more. If you have any difficulty, you can always call back.